Namaste, teachers, parents, grandparents, students, and of course, the batch of 2021. Welcome to your graduation ceremony. This year, our very special celebration takes place in undoubtedly difficult circumstances. Over the past year and a half now, we've seen this batch go through an incredibly challenging final year of school, faced with every possible challenge that could be thrown at them. But despite everything, they've overcome every single hurdle and made it out to the other side even stronger. To the batch of 2021, we've looked up to you, sought to follow in your footsteps, and turned to you for advice in every situation. You've been there for us whenever we've needed you, and for that, we truly cannot thank you enough.
Today, we want to focus on the legacy you're all going to be leaving behind. We want to show you just how impactful each and every single one of you has been to the entire school community. We want to tell you just how much we're all going to miss you. Students and teachers, juniors and seniors, didis and bhaiyas, and the hallways of the place you've called home for the last 14 years. So now, in typical TSRS fashion, we're going to shower you with all the love we have for you, with sentimental gestures and speeches, and a mixture of laughter and tears that always follow a successful TSRS graduation ceremony.
Light and brightness have always been equated with positivity and are seen as the harbingers of good. Without further ado, we'll commence today's celebration with the lighting of the lamp.
Sabu kama ngana ho, sabu kama ngana ho.
As the song signifies, we wish you a lifetime of happiness and success. On that auspicious note, we would like to invite the chairperson of the Sri Ram Schools, Sri Arun Bharat Ramji, to address the virtual gathering.
Dear students who are graduating this year, teachers, parents, grandparents, this is the first time we are having a situation where we are not able to have a physical get together to celebrate the graduation of the children who have finished school in 21. There are always events in our lives which are beyond our control, and COVID has been one of those terrible experiences that all of us have had to live through, many with tragedies in our families and many with debilitating effects in our families. Nevertheless, humankind always overcomes such problems, and I'm absolutely sure that this will also be a passing phase and we will be back to our normal lives sooner than later. I don't want to call you children anymore. You are grown-ups. You will be now entering a life which is going to be very different from what you had for the last 14 years or so, where you were tutored, mentored by your teachers, by your parents, in an environment which was a closed environment in many ways, but also gave you the freedom to explore the world. One thing that has happened is that we have learned how to pick up the challenge of COVID and learn through the virtual classroom, an experience none of us had ever even thought would be possible. I know that it has been a difficult time for you young girls and boys. And I think the most difficult thing that has happened is the fact that you've not been able to contact your classmates, that you've not been able to have that bonhomie that exists between you. But I'm sure that even though the final year of your school life has been on a virtual platform, you will be able to keep your contacts with your classmates, and after the pandemic is over, you will get together, you will meet, and you will re-establish the bonds that you had for so many years. I want to thank the teachers for having done an outstanding job in having taught you through the virtual medium. It's not been easy for you. It's not been easy for the teachers. It's been a difficult time. But kudos to all for having done such a wonderful job. Most of the results are still awaited, but I'm very confident that, as always in the past, you will excel and you will get into universities of your choice, and that you will keep the Sri Ram flag flying high. I know that you are leaving this institution with good values, values that have been provided by your teachers, values that have been provided by your parents, grandparents, and I do hope that you will continue to hold on to these values and be torchbearers for our nation in the future. I wish you all the very best, and I know that you will keep in touch with your alma mater and that you will come back to visit us and keep us informed as to what is happening in your lives. All the very best. Good luck.
Thank you so much, sir, for your inspiring and thoughtful words. I'm sure they offer all of us an opportunity to reflect and seek inspiration from. May I now request you to please join us in welcoming Kshitij Gangwal, batch of 2001, Vice President and Board Member of the TSRS Alumni Association. He will tell us a little bit about the membership to this prestigious organization, which has over 2,100 alumni associated with it. So, may I now invite you to kindly address the outgoing batch.
Good morning, batch of 2021. I'm Kshitij Gangwal, Vice President and Board Member of the TSRS Alumni Association. I'm from the batch of 2001. Yes, that's exactly 20 years older to you all. Firstly, congratulations to each and every one of you on graduating from this prestigious institution. Some of you may be relieved that the school is finally over and excited for new beginnings in your academic careers. But trust me, after a few years, each and every one of you will miss and want to relive these past years at school. It's been 20 years my friends and I have graduated, but we're still in touch with so many teachers from the school. They're more like our friends now, just a call away for any guidance or just a friendly catch-up. Most of your closest friends will be your friends from school. I cannot emphasize enough how important it is to remain connected, maybe for college guidance, networking, or job hunting. The chances of having fellow TSRS alumni in a college or university or in a city where you're moving to are very probable, and they'll always want to come out and help you or hang out with you. I urge you to become registered members of the TSRS Alumni Association so that the alumni office can connect with you in the coming years and be of any kind of help to you. The alumni office organizes various networking opportunities where you can meet and speak to fellow alumni who are successfully established in their fields. Please be in the lookout for the link in your and your parents' emails for the registration for the Alumni Association. Congratulations once again, and we welcome you as proud TSRS alumni.
Thank you so much, sir. That was extremely informative. We are sure that our graduating batch will take your words to heart and are eagerly looking forward to joining this fraternity. Next, we'd like to call upon one of your teachers to take us through today's ceremony. She's someone who's seen you right from the start of your high school journeys grow into the young adults that you are today, and is someone who holds a very special place in all of our hearts. Rupa ma'am, may I please invite you to conduct this part of today's celebration.
Namaskar. The next part of this ceremony is just a little different to the one that is traditionally celebrated in school every year. Much as we would have liked to have our children graduating from our presence today, we know that the next best way is for them to be blessed at home by their parents, safe and protected in their own sheltered environment. The same customs are being used there, however, so that the procedure may be replicated as closely as possible. This momentous occasion cannot be considered complete without a small number of ceremonies to celebrate it. The first is the application of the tilak. The tilak is a mark of auspiciousness. It is put on the forehead with sandal paste, sacred ashes, or kumkum. The tilak is supreme at the initiation of any important ceremony. The next is the angavastradan, the draping of the auspicious unstitched cloth around the shoulders. May the good wishes and blessings of the giver be gathered in plenty by the receiver. Then is the presentation of the Shri emblem. This immensely moving ritual symbolizes the conferring of Shri, representing prosperity, not merely of wealth, but also of knowledge and excellence, on the recipient and the awakening of the individual's inner jyoti. Finally, is the gift of a lamp by the parent school association. This signifies the rite of passage of the individual, brimful of integrity and sensitivity, full of pride in his culture, going out into the world towards his ultimate enlightenment.
Thank you so much, Rupa ma'am. You've been someone who we can always count on, and I'm sure I speak for the entire batch of 21 when I say that we are so grateful to have had you here conducting the ceremony today. We're sure that for the graduating batch, seeing your names up on the screen alongside your peers and the carrying out of our institution's long established traditions, this is going to be one of the many special moments of school that will always occupy a place in your hearts. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
we'll be having the much-awaited speeches by our outgoing heads of council. Pritika, you've been a pillar of strength for all of us. We know that you're there to give us the most honest advice whenever we need it. Thank you for always being one call away. Dhruv, you're someone who every single junior has looked up to. Thank you for making us feel so comfortable in talking to you and opening up to you about everything. I think I speak on behalf of myself and the entire school when I say that we could not have asked for two better heads of council. I know that you both have always spoken to us about how afraid you are to be forgotten, but we genuinely believe that you're leaving behind the strongest legacy. When all the odds are stacked up against you, you showed us how to handle pressure the right way, and that is something that truly deserves enormous respect. Without further ado, may I now invite both of you to please deliver your speeches.
It's 7:56 a.m. In a last-minute desperate attempt, you begin your journey on foot. Racing by the cars lined up one behind the other, you finally make it to the gate, only to realize that inner voices calling you is halfway over, Ripple Ma'am is standing next to the guard bhaiya, and in addition to your late arrival, you aren't wearing school socks. Your saving grace, however, is the rain. Instead of scribbling your name on the register of shame and spending 10 minutes reflecting on your grave mistake, you're simply told to hurry up and get to class. The smell of rain fills the air. The corridors are wet and my hair is extremely frizzy, but you make it up all four floors of the MBR building to realize that your first class is physics, a sheer stroke of luck. Your class then proceeds to spend the next 50 minutes periodically interrupting KK sir to tell him that it is raining and how the rain must be celebrated because of its extreme cultural, agricultural and historical importance, and that the only way to correctly honour the rain gods is to stand outside and dance in the rain along with Rahul sir's class. I would give anything to be late to school one last time. Unlike the batches before us, we didn't get to spend our last year repeating our mischiefs from the years before. Instead, our year of lasts was filled with firsts. For the first time, waking up at 8:20 a.m. meant one more snooze. You couldn't just smile and get away with not doing that English long answer. Seeing Rabina ma'am in the corridor didn't mean that you needed to scramble and quickly tie up your hair. For the first time, our lives were compressed onto a 7x7 Teams window, spending 7 hours a day staring at multicolored circles of mismatched letters and numbers. Namaste parents, teachers, students, and most importantly, the batch of 2021. Today is a special day. It's a day we celebrate a beast of a batch, a collection of the most artistic, witty, creative, talented, kind, and loving people I know. To all 161 of you, congratulations. We made it, and we made it together. And there's no other group of people that I would rather have spent the past 4 years with. Together, we put on a form evening in 6 days. Six. I will truly never forget the terribly fitting costumes, Amore playing in the background, all the samosas we ate, and the mixed fruit juice we hated on. For the record, mixed fruit is definitely the superior juice, and I don't care what you say. Together, we saw the sheer panic on a couple's face when they realized that Barkha ma'am and Sushil ma'am had finally caught on. Together, we made code names for each other. In a terrible mess of who likes who, this only ever led to more confusion. I mean, what were we even trying to do? Hide the fact that every girl in our grade had fallen for either Zubin or Bhan? Together, we came up with long-winded explanations for why we were late to class, despite the fact that three teachers had already seen us playing on the basketball court during math. Together, we tried and failed to do an entire act of Tempest in the bus on the day of an exam, only to realize that when you're doing Shakespeare for the first time, it truly is another language and there's no point trying at all. For any juniors watching, if there's anything you take from the speech, it should be this: do not leave English literature to the last second. Together, we witnessed the last minute rush at CCD, surrounded by juniors precariously carrying their tiny cuppa noodle boxes as if they were their most prized possessions, trying to make it to the bus without spilling anything. Together we went from being the little kids who thought that the 12th graders were the pinnacle of being cool, smart, charming and talented to being the very cool, extremely smart, mostly tall and slightly charming graduating batch. We made it, and we made it together. My first time in school was when I came to give the entrance test. I remember sitting in the library, staring outside the tinted windows, and I could see the IB girls walking around with their rolled up skirts, the 12 feet tall basketball players shouting to each other from one end of the corridor to the other, asking what was there for lunch to see if it was worth making the trek to the lunch hall. And I remember thinking to myself, this place is extremely chaotic. Looking back, it's that very chaos of school. The last minute changes in events, dancing in the rain, bunking classes for official council duties, and everything in between that made school so much fun. My first day also happened to be the day of a math unit test. It was also the day that I met my arch nemesis. This person went and begged for an extra half mark in a class 9 geography class test just so that she could say that she beat me. Dear Rumka, I have no idea how we went from rivals to best friends, but the past 4 years would not have been the same without you. You will always be my favorite bully, professional chemistry note taker, and complaining about the fact that we took science, buddy. Thank you for always reserving a seat for me in class, full on tackling anyone who wrote on the whiteboard without your permission, and always sharing your pesto sandwich. I love you. 9 and 10 D was a special class. The boys were yelling Toshi bro and tossing around Aryan like he was a paper airplane. Ravtej was tormenting Tara Mathur by stealing her pencil pouch and putting it in the dustbin, and Kabir was telling us ghost stories. The 6 hour long game of controversy in the bus on the way back from de-stress has scarred me for life and will definitely never be forgotten. Amidst it all, there was one thing that united us like nothing else. We were Sangeeta ma'am's Nalayaks, a badge that we wore with pride while flexing how abysmal our math marks were. Sangeeta ma'am, thank you for being the first class teacher in Shriram and for always believing in me. We will cherish the 2 years that we spent in your classroom, and we absolutely love you for taking us to the math lab so that we could sit in the AC. Vani, I have no idea if you're listening to this or not, but I have to say it. Thank you for being my first friend here. Your strength, talent and perseverance inspires me every day, and there is no one I'm prouder of. Tara, the only person who will apologize for apologizing too much. Tara Mathur, the world needs more people like you, people who care. You will always be the mom of our grade, and I love you for that. Soon enough, the end of grade 10 rolled around, and it brought with it the exams that our parents and teachers had been hyping up for our entire lives. I think it's safe to say that boards made our batch go a little crazy. Akshat was on his 20th revision, Riya Puri had made notes for English language, and the all-nighters group was, well, up all night asking each other topography questions. We gave our boards while drinking copious amounts of coffee in the gym, and all of a sudden, it was done. We were officially the cool seniors who could drop the subjects they didn't like. Most of us were wise with our subject choices. Most does not include Samarth, Yuvraj, Parth or me. Our collective anguish over taking physics and wanting to do economics in college was insurmountable. If I had to do it all again, I would happily associate myself with the people who discovered fire last year, if it means never having to look at electrostatics again. Grade 11 also brought a special family into my life. 11S, the obviously superior science section and Ripple Ma'am's favorite class. I mean, nothing really tops an in-house band starring Adhyan Chaitanya and the borrowed guitar from the theater room, or the teacher's table that was routinely exploited by Chintya for daily TT tournaments. The fact that we had to walk up one extra floor compared to the humanities kids was a human rights violation. But if you made it up to the fourth floor with the supposedly studious science kids, here's what you'd find. You'd find Thade in the corner doing finger push-ups, Devansh, Dhananjay, Agastya and Nirvan, not there, basketball court, and Inan was our supreme leader, Mr. Kim Jung. The only people with any semblance of academic control, Malika, Aisha, Diya and Maitreya, were there with their perfect notes, Dipankar, Dilawar and Pavit bonding over Fitji, and Akshat and Anushka just bonding. A huge thank you to our class teachers, Sudhi ma'am, Poonam ma'am and Anam ma'am, for dealing with us and all our antics for the last 2 years. Thank you for everything. The SEPW court piece, nicknames, Zoom concerts, and of course the CT period push-up competitions. Barkha ma'am, thank you for being the teacher that I could always say anything to. Your confidence in me made me more confident in myself, and I will always be extremely grateful for the 3 years that I spent in your classroom. Vasati ma'am, the trip to Japan remains to be one of my fondest memories, and I will never forget our chat in the airplane. Dhanvanti ma'am, thank you for always being there for me, for listening to every crazy idea and correcting me where I faltered. To every teacher that taught our batch, whether it was in PV or class 12, thank you for your constant support and incredible patience that you needed to deal with this lot. We're here because of you. Pavit Singh, thank you for being the person who never failed to make me laugh. Here's to every chem practical that we practically co-wrote, every time we made eye contact and knew that neither of us had absolutely no idea what was going on, every gossip session and advice session, you've been such an integral part of my journey. Watching you lead Vasundhara the way you have, with so much passion and compassion, makes me so proud of my favourite South Indian vegetarian Sardar. Samaj Shreya Sarthak Sami Jain, I can't tell what's most complex, your name, mysterious heritage, accent, or the trajectory that made you the designated gossip girl of our batch. You guys, we need to be scared because Samar Jain knows way too much, and I think we should all be extremely scared for when he finally releases that expose. Thank you for being someone I can always count on through the carpools, tuitions, poster making, and Hamilton snobbery. Thank you to you and Alia. The car rides to a party will always be more fun than the party itself. The beginning of 2020 brought with it the most hyped event of the year. 12S1 had been planning this event for months. The contestants had been prepped, acoustics in each venue had been tested, and the invites had been sent out. The publicity around any social media boxing event has nothing on what happened on a fateful Friday in 11S1, the infamous Kasbra versus Tejas Chopra fight turned rap battle. It had all the elements of a disaster waiting to happen. Terrible location, it shared a wall with a staff room, and a flaky organizer, some of them looking right at you, who left before anything had even started. It's safe to say that we had our very own fire festival on our hands. On the topic of disasters, we spent our last year at home. The beginning of quarantine marked several transformations. Divanch Dev became Saucy Dev, the coffee that our parents had been making for us for years became Dalgona coffee, and all of a sudden, everyone was either a newfound home chef or entrepreneur. One thing that didn't change, however, was that we were always there for each other. We were there to celebrate every little victory, to obsess over whether exams were happening or not, but most of all, we were there when things got tough. When the going got tough, we were there for each other, trying to find hospital beds, oxygen cylinders, and medicines for our loved ones. We became a support system for each other, and I know this is a support system that will last a lifetime. To the group that was named Sathvik Pass Ho Gaya on the day exams got cancelled, I just want to say one thing. Goa Kasoli Jaipur grad, na kuch bhi nahi hoega. I'm telling you, we'll all be sitting in Cyber Hub having Taco Bell like we do after every exam season. We're incapable of making a plan, guys. We need to give up. Kabir, thank you for being the best dance partner for movie night, form evening and grad. Watch out, world. He's going to be the best filmmaker out there. Pranit, you asked for a sneak peek of my grad speech. Little did I know that this sneak peek would lead to you finding grammatical mistakes and nothing else. Nevertheless, thank you for always checking up on me and being the person that I can turn to always. Chahat and Atiria, a few of my first and constant friends at Shiram. I know that even if we ever drift out or are out of touch, all it takes is a few seconds and some yum yum cha food to put into perspective just how special both of you are to me. Surbhi, you complete me. And somehow Ritesh sir had the foresight to see that and made me your conscience in form evening. Zara, whether it's SEPW or tuition, you've been a constant in school and to know you is to love you, and I love you so very much. Aryan, I really don't think you're listening to this. You're probably sending a 10-minute long voice note to some poor junior telling them to move an icon 1 centimeter to the right, obsessing over a font choice or perfecting a color palette for a logo. Your talent truly has no bounds, and I'm so happy that we get to work with each other, even in CS, even after school. Dhruv, Pavit, Ronit, Adya, Ayati, Tia, Pranit, Jayashri, Shubham, Karan, Keshav, Samarth, Tara, Aryan, and Vikram. Thank you for being the best counsel I could have ever asked for. Through all the challenges that were thrown at us, disagreements, online events, several long days and nights, we didn't just survive, we thrived. Also, our junior council is now a senior council who has a junior council. So it's safe to say that we're very, very old. And as an 18-year-old, it sounds odd, but I truly feel very old. Janni ma'am and Meghna ma'am, thank you for holding us together. Without you, none of us would ever have had any direction. If we ever got anything done, it was because of you and the crazy hours that you put in to make our lives easier. Manika ma'am, Manisha ma'am, and Madhur ma'am, thank you for being our constant support, for always hearing us out and guiding us through this past year. Dhruv, I couldn't have done this without you. Your humor and wit, along with empathy and kindness, always being able to say the right thing for every situation, makes you the best head boy the school has ever seen. I mean it. I consider myself extremely lucky to have worked with you and gained a wonderful friend in the process. Diya and Adil, you'll be standing up here very soon. The time in between planning a grad and graduating goes by in a blink of an eye, even if it is 20 months long like it was for us. So all I can say is enjoy it. Savor every second. You have our complete trust, and I know that you're going to be doing a fabulous job. And then there was one. Lucille Arora, I have no words. From normal calls to WhatsApp calls to Skype to Zoom to FaceTime and then back to Zoom, you have been my constant. The long walks and lunch turned into 6-hour long calls, doing BuzzFeed quizzes and assigning every person that we know a combination of Gilmore Girls characters. There is one habit, however, that I will never forgive you for teaching me. The art of procrastinating all work till 4 a.m. on the day it's due to finish it. As I'm writing part of the speech at 4 a.m, I can attest it's definitely not fun. Lucille, at some point you became family, and I'm so glad you did, because there's no way I would have survived the past 4 years without your sassy comments and constant commentary. Thank you for being the lane to my Rory, the soy sauce to my sushi, and the head of content to my head of action. Stay lit, bro. It's been good doing business with you. To my family, Papa, Mom, and Max. You see, last year, during investiture, my parents sat through all the speeches that the council gave. So they have these crazy high expectations of what the speech is supposed to be. Mom has expressed to me innumerable times over the past year that the sole purpose of my speech is to get her to cry. I'm not quite sure I've done that, but Mama, Papa, thank you for everything. Thank you for loving food as much as I do, for waking up at 5 a.m. to take 10-year-old Prithika to the basketball morning practice, even though I don't have a single athletic bone in my body. Thank you for every opportunity I've ever gotten. I know I don't say it enough, but I love you. To my grandparents, Margie, thank you for making the best kheer in the world and for being our pillar of strength. The past year hasn't been easy. Daddy, we miss you every day. But I know that you're looking down on us and are with us all the time, and all I can do is hope that we make you proud. Nanu, the way that you wrap up life lessons with every story so casually has taught me so much about everything, from atomic physics to just being a good person, and thank you for that. Nani, you always have this cool, calm attitude, something that you have not passed on to Mom, but it's something that I definitely admire. You're my friend, and thank you for always being there. When council results were announced last year, it was made abundantly clear to me through several threats that a graduation speech without a junior school mention would get me cancelled. Honestly, I've only ever visited junior school a couple times, so this section is definitely crowdsourced, but here goes. It's when you end a journey that you go back to the beginning, to where it all began. Snakes and ladders next to the PV classrooms, the red slides, precariously positioned clay room, and the novelty of wearing home clothes on your birthday, those are just some of the things that made Vasant Vihar magical. It's the weirdest feeling to be giving this speech to an empty auditorium. Instead of staring out into a sea of red kurtas and familiar faces, all I see is empty chairs and Janima, Meghna, Ma'am, Dhruv, and our parents. There's no hole in the Audi, but it's never been emptier. It's all a stark reminder of how much things have changed. Despite having 8 extra months to let it sink in, it still somehow doesn't seem real. It doesn't seem real that we've had our last school samosa, we've been on our last outstation trip, and we've spent our last day in school as non-alumni. The goodbye is always hard, and as we leave what has been our world for the last 2, 4, or 14 years, all I can say is thank you to that world. The Shriram School Moulsari, you have given us everything and made us people worthy of graduating today in this red kurta. Regardless of where we are, we will always look back on our times here with the fondest memories of the laughs, the dancing, and the rain, and the friends. Thank you for everything. For the last time, this is Prithika Vij, your head girl, but most importantly, a member of the batch of 2021, saying thank you from the bottom of my heart.
4th of April, 2014, my first day as a Shriramite. After 6 years of desperately trying to shift schools, I was finally a student at the highly prestigious Moulsari campus, a place where I was sure I would be challenged intellectually. Little did I know that the second I walk into school, Rafael Shiva Mitra would point to my head and scream, "Bro, what is happening? That's the fourth pagri guy in our class." but the surprises kept rolling in. Guys, the first two people to get detention from our grade weren't Sridatta or Agastya, it was Vidush and Achintya, who in their 50 innocence broke the classroom clock with a moon ball. Even more weirdly, while I came in expecting a toxically competitive environment, Moulsari was overly generous with opportunities. So much so that our 6th grade form evening, a Rajasthani rendition of Pinocchio, had 12 pappus and 9 ganpakshes. Do you understand how long it took for me to explain to my dadi that Rijul and Tejas Taneja played the same character? Shriram was nothing like I had imagined. But it was better. Perfectly imperfect in a way that letting go is just too hard now. Namaskar and a very good morning to Mr. Arun Bharatram, Mrs. Vasi Bharatram, Mrs. Radhika Bharatram, Manika ma'am, Manisha ma'am, Madhur ma'am, parents, grandparents, over-supportive chachus and buas, teachers, students, but most importantly, the batch of 2021. Before I turn the clock and attempt to take us down memory lane, I'm going to start this stopwatch for two reasons. Reason number one is because it's become an extension of myself. I've carried it everywhere from debate tournaments to exam halls, despite the judgmental looks both from Raghav Verma and Atul sir, so it's only fitting if it's by my side at our graduation ceremony. Reason number two is something I'll reveal a little later. We're a complicated set of people, but things were a lot more straightforward back in 6th grade. Every boy knew that Raghav Chugh had a monopoly over two things, match attacks and conch, and every girl knew that Noor had a monopoly over two things, Adya and Tia. Nobody else will understand the kind of influence that these two had. When Raghav wore a turtleneck under a house t-shirt and trousers instead of shorts, he single-handedly established a new uniform code for boys. But while the whole grade was focused on catching up with the latest fashion trends, Gaurav Bindra instead had his eyes set on another goal: irritating every girl in 6C. As a young, impressionable fellow Bindra, I followed in his footsteps as we teased Chahat for her creative email address, chattychahat@gmail.com, annoyed Shreya by repeatedly screaming, "I'm sorry, Shreya," and encouraged every girl to stand for class rep, only to rig the elections and elect a chair, like a physical blue chair was our class rep for an entire month. However, looking back, I realize how immature this was and really regret it. So I just want to say, I'm sorry, Shreya. But even amongst all this childlike simplicity, we had some really complex moments as a batch. I remember when Agastya first told me that on every outstation trip, the girls would have their annual fight. And I didn't really believe it until I saw Livana literally go up to Tara Mathur and say, "Hey, does 7 PM suit you for the fight?" But even if I didn't quite understand things, I was beginning to love them. Shriram became home and the people, not just students, but even teachers, became family. I'll never forget how Jayanti ma'am told Gaurav and I to improve our Hindi vocabulary, so we learned the highly academic lyrics of Char Botal Vodka, how Resha ma'am tried to convince the senior admin that my Spanish oral should get an 11 out of 10, or the amazing childhood stories that we'd hear in our English classes. Renu ma'am, we dearly miss your presence today, and your adorable stories of roly-poly hills will always be cherished memories for your students of 6C. Before we knew it, a year had passed and we found ourselves in class 7. You knew we were getting older because Rafael was now onto his 9th serious relationship and Gaurav and I started befriending girls instead of irritating them. Guys, what I'm about to tell you is a true story. One Friday, Zoha, Ila, Vani, Gaurav and I decided that we didn't want to go for the swimming class. After intensely brainstorming excuses over a plate of honey chili potatoes, we came up with the perfect solution. Gaurav and I went up to Sandeep sir and told him we couldn't swim because our turbans would get wet and we didn't know how to tie them. He understood and let us go. Then Zoha, Ila, Vani went up together and told sir it was that time of the month. Sandeep sir blushed and then also let them go. Unnat Sodi, seeing all of this unfold, also decided to take action and told sir he wouldn't be able to swim either. Sandeep sir got really annoyed and asked him why. It took Unnat a full 5 seconds to realize that he didn't wear a turban. So this boy, who was playing chopsticks during the growing up workshop, said with full confidence, "Sir, even for me, it is that time of the month." Now, you'd think that Sandeep sir would scream, but he was the one playing chopsticks with Unnat during the workshop. So he just scratched his head and let Unnat go. Class 9 was also really special because I made one of the best decisions of my life, going to the football field during lunches. Here, Neil Singh and I, both unfit, subpar footballers, would team up each day as Bas Singh Bindra and somehow gain superhero powers, beating the likes of Keshav, Valmek, Chaitanya, Siddhan Sinha and Ansh. All of them wearing pro combats because Raghav Chugh decided turtlenecks were too 2014. Class 7 was made even more special with the teachers. Janani ma'am managed to scar the entire section by explaining how exactly female infanticide works. Indu ma'am commissioned Gaurav and I to produce Santa Banta plays on geography concepts. Priya Lal ma'am passionately expressed how she felt about Raphael at the start of each class. And I'll never forget biology classes, where Raphael passionately expressed how he felt about Sugandha ma'am at the start of each class. But I especially want to thank my class teacher for 7 and 8. Akanksha ma'am. Ma'am, words can't do justice to the impact that you've had on my life. I'll never forget the 7th grade PTM where you made me promise you that I'd stand for head boy. I'm here today because you believed in me before I did. Then in 8th grade, we started to get a bit more serious. Mindspark and riders were replaced by final exams, deed became life skills, and SOF Olympiads became a popularity contest that Adhyan won by default. But in times of change, there is always a renaissance. And Ariman Parashar, Raftej, Ahan and Vikram introduced our batch to two wonderful things. Bappi Lehri stickers and Harass Corner. Every morning for that entire year, these four would get printouts of Bappi Lehri and stick them on any surface they could find and then push each other in a small section of 8C while screaming Harass Corner. Class 8 also featured, in my opinion, the best outstation trip ever. I'll never forget the bus rides where Noor, Karan, Simmer and I theorized that every Punjabi person was related, and an extremely stressed out Pavit ran up to Noor afterwards and in the most charming way of asking a girl out says, "Am I your preferable?" But the best moment was perhaps when Keshav sir figured out that Ronit, Valmik, Karan, Siddhant, Nigam and I smuggled in Keshav Vaidya into our room, breaking the limit of 5 boys staying together. He knocked in the middle of the night, found Keshav Vaidya hiding in the bathroom and yelled, "You think you're too smart? I am five smart." At the end of class 8, our batch split up with the opening of IGCSE. In an instant, it went from 1 to 2, a transformation that Ronit's eyebrows are far too familiar with. But while old friendships may have begun to drift apart, they're never fading from memory. Gaurav, you're the reason Shriram quickly became a home, and it's no surprise that every teacher thought we were related because you'll always be a brother to me. Neil, from the broccoli song in our outstation trip talent show to yelling Nijman Griezmann at every opportunity we'd get, thank you for being my best friend all these years. Raphael, whether it was coming up with codes like DBDG to continue discussing your relationships during class or busting open a locked desk with a Milton bottle only to find copies of Alcoholics Anonymous in English, Hindi and Gurumukhi, I think it's safe to say that you've made me laugh the most. Zoha, I still miss your churros, Sabudana tikkis and carpool gossip. Ila, I will never forget Man Crush Mondays or GDFR. And Vani, you're the strongest person I know. Ariman and Raftej, thank you for not recording any more YouTube videos. And to everyone else, Divansh, Vikram, Sahasini, Raseel, Atiria, Utkarsh, DK, Tejaswini, Rosemala, Anish and Adi, thank you for shaping the person I am today. But back then, I still remember all the excitement and buzz around meeting the new kids. Particularly one struggling YouTuber, Samanity YT. Initially, it was really hard for me to speak with Samarth because between Zoha, Nayantara and Sanaya, he was just too busy. However, over time, I found some of my best friends in that batch. Raghav, Sam, Sid and I would sit at the back of every computer science class and do everything but computer science. Priyanka ma'am, do you remember that one day you forgot to come to class until the last 2 minutes and found me drawing an extremely elaborate diagram on the board? Well, Neil and Devansh may have convinced you that I was teaching the class about output devices, but really, we were just convincing Mahima that her real name should have been M-Dog. Class 9 was just fooling around in this way. Physics classes were us debating religion and marriage with Binay sir, who as a married man himself very weirdly was against the idea of marriage. Economics classes with Pritha ma'am featured Vedant, Ahan and I screaming Jumla every time we learnt of a new economic scam. And till date, I don't really know what happened in Vinod sir's math classes. Now, the transition into class 10 was supposed to be scary, a turning point in our academic lives. But instead, we spent a year making memes on Trishla the sharpshooter, focusing on post-exam promenade plans more than the actual test, and circulating voice messages on back massages and Devashish's need for solid proof and false allegations. Namita ma'am, thank you for giving me a wake-up call in the form of a 9 out of 40 in my history paper. Even though it was a very public result that somehow landed up in the school magazine, and I still don't understand who thought it was okay to print that, it was exactly the jhatka I needed to finally get down to studying. But even through this time that was supposed to be incredibly stressful, I never felt overwhelmed because of the incredible support system around me. Raghav Korn Verma, we may have started talking because you brought the best different food to school, but I think it's safe to say that it wasn't the Theobroma brownie that made my life a bit sweeter, it was you. Thank you for being my hilarious therapist all these years. Ronit, I can't imagine my Shriram journey without you. From LMUN to GEMS, from Ambi Valley to Siath, from being Dhruv and Ronit to Dhronit, you've grown to be such an important part of my life. Soin, thank you for all the carpool rides where we'd stop at the ice cream ready right outside school and then fight to treat each other, and especially for being the nicest guy I'll ever know. Valmik, you really inspire me, and I can't believe that you've never cheated on a test. You're the goofiest yet somehow funniest person, and I'm so glad we took that walk together in the 8th grade outstation trip. Madhav, from taking classes together to get better at just a minute to attending a documentary making summer camp, I've loved doing the most random stuff with you. Samarth Samuel Samrat, from supporting me as I recited my 3D printer rap as a poem to the students of Ghiyasuddin International School, Maldives, to almost writing a book with Suryansh that was set to change the world, but stopping last minute because we realized we needed more perspective. Thank you for all the amazing memories. Vedant, you're the only guy who would spend free periods with me in the physics lab doing SAT math question banks. I'm really going to miss playing around the world, producing the most catchy songs and sharing a tanky online addiction. Amartya, from that time in international math to now playing hours of Warzone, you've really been at the heart of violence. I'm sorry, and thank you for always making us laugh with highly intellectual questions like, bro, how many movies are in your top 5? Rohit, I still don't understand the levels of Goku Super Saiyan or how you managed to escape the Fat Gang, but here's to many more nights of Maggie Under the Moon. Ahan, you may have scared Vasudatta ma'am in the 6th grade with your dark humor, and again Brinalini ma'am in the 10th grade with your gory imagination, but I'm glad at least I saw the side of you that laughs at the dumbest jokes, silliest poems, and every mention of the name Jigyasu. Tyra, thank you for randomly bursting into laughter at the most awkward moments and never ceasing to make us all smile. And Anvi, I still can't believe that the start of this friendship was when you got angry I took your sharpener, so you scratched me with your bare nails until I bled. But I've had such a blast with the youth symposium and singing Hakuna Matata in the corridors. And everyone else, Devashish, Anya, Niyamat, Pia, Husnal, Simar and Kashyap, thank you for making school even more special. With 10th boards finally out of the way, we found ourselves in 11th, which was the best year of my life for three reasons. Trying to connect with IB, reconnecting with the batch, and realizing the disconnect with my family. So, on to the first. Entering IB, we were all fed horror stories from our seniors about how the curriculum sucks the joy out of life, but as it turns out in true Shriram fashion, reality was nothing like the expectations set. I'll admit that when Piku ma'am first gave me a 0 out of 24 in the history assignment, then a 0 out of 24 in the second history assignment, and a 2 in the third, which sounds like an improvement, but the paper was out of 100, I was very, very scared. But over time, the bubble bursts and you begin to have fun. Perhaps the best example is that by the second month of IB, the entire history group would hide in the closets of the classroom, and the second Piku ma'am would enter, we would jump out and surprise her by screaming Piku boo, or when we'd all coordinate during class to stand up together at 12:08 p.m. sharp, but Piku ma'am would just continue teaching as if nothing had happened. On the opposite end of the enthusiastic teacher spectrum was KKK sir, who more politically correctly is just called KK sir. Sir has cracked the code on how to avoid children bunking your class. He bunks them himself. On that note, it's also worth mentioning Ruben's first day at Shriram. At the beginning of the math class, he asked Vinod sir if he could go to the bathroom, came back 45 minutes later with an orange jello and a Tex-Mex veg, and Vinod sir just looked at him and asked for a bite. But that isn't to say that all students were joking around. Unfortunately, the IB encourages asking questions, and there are two students from our batch who completely abused this privilege, Madhav Kakkad and Devashish Chhabra, and both for very different reasons. Madhav would ask questions with too many terms you don't know about, and Devashish would ask questions with too many terms you shouldn't know about. Meghna ma'am, I don't know how you put up with our section for the last 2 years, but hats off to you, Dipika ma'am and Vinod sir for handling our group. I'm also really going to miss Spanish classes with Isha ma'am, where Ishan Tulli would start off each class by announcing that he's going on a diet and then proceed to munch aloo bhujia for the next hour. English classes with Rupa ma'am, which was 10% actual work, 15% hearing personal anecdotes, and 75% was just discussing the English syllabus every class, or economics classes where I was guilty of annoying the teachers too much. Harbina ma'am, I still remember when you checked my first term paper where I drew 11 out of 11 diagrams incorrectly. You're the only teacher who has told my mom, "Isko sab kuch aata hai, magar kuch nahi aata." Thank you for sitting with me during PE classes to handhold me through the most basic concepts. And Pritha ma'am, I'm sorry I wouldn't even let you go during summer vacations, but co-writing that research paper and begging you for 2 years straight to present an analysis on the Indian budget will always be fond memories of mine. Ripple ma'am, I can't believe that you agreed to be my EE supervisor for English literature. There aren't too many teachers who'd agree to do so after a student responds to the question, "Which is the last book you've read?" with Amar Chitra Katha, The Mystery of Kalia. But through every meeting or Zoom call, you've been nothing but patient with me, and I'll dearly miss our interactions. IB also happened to be the time that I grew close to the smallest basketball player, Adya Rajpal. Adu Padu, I'm going to miss us stealing tiffin food from the entire grade, walking around campus and being the biggest teacher suck-ups. But I cannot wait to go to college with you and continue our endless discussions of being scared about life, overanalyzing every bit of our personalities and being excited at every small opportunity. The truth is, there's nobody else I'd rather spend the next 4 years with. Now, onto the second reason for me loving that year, reconnecting with the batch. After the initial IGCSE drift, I remember stressing that the 11th grade form evening might be a weird experience, but I was so happy that things didn't change. Raseel was still AD, Ritesh sir was still Raseel's AD, Tejas Chopra and Taneja would burst out into random beatbox performances, and Samarth Jain continued speaking in his completely authentic British accent. I'm so glad that Ritesh sir managed to make this another memorable performance, and Sridatta, Sahil, Surbhi, Kabir, Tia, Dipankar, Riya, Tara and Aarti, I'm incredibly grateful that we got talking again. By the time we had SUPW, everything seemed normal again. We sat by the bonfire singing songs, the girls had another annual fight, and Rafael spent a few hours summarizing the relationships he had in the last week. The final highlight was perhaps planning the best grad ever. From the decor, to music, to dances, to the play, guys, we showed everyone what our batch is capable of. On to the final reason, realizing the disconnect with my family. I remember coming back from the 11th grade SUPW trip and almost every parent had come to pick up their child, but I looked around for almost an hour and found no sign of my parents. I categorically remember how annoyed I was, and when I came back home, I refused to even talk to them. But that's when they sat me down, first apologized, and then told me the reason they weren't able to. Papa had just been diagnosed with stage 2 CKD. But looking back, I feel so ashamed that I repeated the same mistake again. Raghav, Ronit and I were Sriram's underdog participants at the Modern World Debates in Dubai, and we somehow managed to win that tournament. I can't forget the way I told Mama Papa off for not calling me to say best of luck before the finals and said they don't care about me, and again. They apologized first and then said they couldn't because Dadaji had multiple seizures, so they had to rush him to the hospital and chose to hide it from me until after the finals so it wouldn't play on my mind. Mama, Papa, I'm so sorry. I don't know if it was the teenage hormones or ridiculous delusions, but I thank my stars every single day for having parents like you. Papa, you're my best friend, my Harry, and you've got to practice FIFA while I'm gone. I can't keep giving you own goals to make it a fair match. I've seen you work through the night so we could sleep well, fight with the world so we wouldn't have to, and do it all with a smile on your face and the most contagious laugh. Mama, you put everything on hold to raise your children. You'll always be my role model, my biggest source of inspiration, and the cutest little woman who won't stop asking to play Monodeal or Ludo King. And don't worry, I promise I'll video call every day to fill you in on the gossip and make study plans that I still won't follow, because trust me, I'm going to miss you the most. Snehal Didi, my self-proclaimed third parent and constant source of support, you've molded the person I am today. From teaching me fractions to how to talk to girls, I've learned a lot from you, but the single biggest lesson is perhaps that there's no one quite like you. You're a little kid with your sense of humor, a complete teenager with your attitude, a total auntie with your nakhra, and a complete dadi with your advice, but you're still and always going to be my favorite person in the whole wide world. To everyone watching this speech, keep your eyes and ears open for soon-to-be Dr. Snehal Bindra, because I assure you, she's going to change the world. Dadima, my Lego building partner, and Dadaji, mere dur ke musafir, It's your Ashirvad and value systems that push the Bindras to be better people, and we love you both so, so much. I can't talk about family and not mention Sahani. Sahan, I know we didn't expect things to end this way, but honestly, I don't regret any of it. You'll always be the safe space I'd vent to about my million problems with life, someone I trust with everything, and the only person who could instantly make me laugh. I'll never again get to practice the grad dance for weeks to impress you, but then on the final day, just be a human shield because your kurti tore mid-performance, or hold your towels for 20 minutes outside the SUPW bathrooms and have Bajaj sir call me whipped in Hindi. But one thing's for sure, Sahani Giroti, you'll always be my high school person. And that finally brings us to this past year, 12th grade. It's funny how during my head boy interview, my attendance record was brought into question, and then the whole year school was only absent. I swear, the only time I used my badge this entire year was to change the SIM card of my phone. But because we lost all these moments, we had to go out there and make new ones. To my council, Pritika, Ronit, Adya, Tia, Vikram, Pavith, Ayati, Karan, Pranit, Keshav, Jayashree, Samarth, Tara, Aryan and Shubham, and the teachers who helped us, Janani ma'am, Meghna ma'am, Madhur ma'am, Manisha ma'am and Manika ma'am, you've all inspired me this past year, and it's been such an amazing experience to work with you. We didn't just have to come up with alternative ways to host assemblies or have elections, but needed to deal with much more stressful tasks, like ensuring Ronit doesn't give another speech. Pritika, I'm so happy to have found one of my best friends in you. Overthinking that every small assembly would shape our legacy or going overboard with scheduling meetings sound really annoying, but somehow you managed to make these very experiences unforgettable. If it wasn't for council, I also wouldn't have grown close to Diya and Adir. Even though you two publicly roasted me in your election speeches, I will guilt you by doing the exact opposite. Being nice, because that's the Shree way. Guys, it feels really comforting to leave the keys to two people I admire more than I'd like to admit. And you've grown to mean a lot to me, so I'm really going to miss our calls of discussing great gossip and brainstorming through council dilemmas. Batch of 2021, you have to admit, despite the irritation of being confined at home or the absolute infuriation at hearing every Indian uncle say the COVID times the new normal, we still managed to make this year very special. We had highly entertaining online classes, like the time that Anya, Adya and Sohani convinced Simran ma'am that they're running an underground boxing club for caste, and Simran ma'am said, wow beta, that will count for creativity, activity and service. Or when Priya ma'am asked a half asleep Ahan to solve a differential equation and he unmuted, said, sorry ma'am, my mic isn't working and went back to sleep. Class 11 and 12 were so different. In class 11, if two children were absent, it was unheard of. In class 12, two children attending was unheard of. In class 11, we studied hard to do well in exams. In class 12, we efficiently used exam.net until one very bright business management student answered the question of defined demand by writing in their paper, award 2 marks to candidates if they mention the terms willing and able. In class 11, Rushil would never come to school. In class 12, okay, I guess some things didn't change. Even outside school, times were different. I thought birthdays hit rock bottom and we stopped having return gifts in class 8, but the Zoom parties from last year were a different ballgame altogether. We'd all just sit in silence and awkwardly smile, then become overly excited when the clock struck 12, but the best part was at the end, when the birthday boy or girl would expect all the acquaintances to leave and close friends to stay back, but you'd always have that one kid who unfortunately thinks they're in the inner circle and just wouldn't leave. I was that one kid. Stuti Gulati, I'm so sorry for ruining your birthday. We may not have expected it, but last year turned out to be such a special one. From experimenting with virtual backgrounds on Teams, to playing COD Mobile and Ludo King until 5 a.m, we managed to keep ourselves distracted from all the chaos outside. But I also just want to take a moment to acknowledge the loss that many of us experienced. If it was a family member, a friend, or just someone you knew, I want you to hear this. The single biggest gift you could leave them with was showing you care. Whether it was praying desperately for hours, hoping they'd get better, frantically calling for nurses or oxygen cylinders, or even celebrating their lives after they left you with beautiful paintings so they could smile at you from above. I'm so proud of you, and I promise, so are they. After 2020, I feel a lot more resilient. Maybe it's the antibodies, but it's probably the experience of being flung far, far outside your comfort zone, but still managing to claw back, come what may. In all this time, I've had the opportunity to look back and reflect on the last few years, and there's one learning I want to share with you all. Throughout high school, I over-glamorized the achievements of people I looked up to. I made the accomplishments of others aspirations of my own. Life just felt like a rat race, jumping from activity to activity without any real sense of what I was doing. I set my desktop background in the 10th grade to a picture of Yale University, not because there was something I specifically liked, but because a senior I idolized got in. I deleted social media and WhatsApp, not because I had a problem with it, but because someone I looked up to said it was a waste of time. I started living life by a stopwatch and overscheduling my days with things I didn't really enjoy. And as I set myself on this path of trying to be more like others, my identity was lost in transit. Honestly, even now I struggle with this issue. Before writing this speech, I thought back to what former head boys had said and felt myself subconsciously trying to copy them. But instead, I asked myself, what do I wish they had said to the chubby Sardar who sat in the auditorium year after year, listening to them in awe? Now, I don't know how many middle schoolers are listening to this live stream, but even if there's just one, here's what I have to say. I'm really worried about you. The world is getting more and more competitive and everyone treats life like a zero-sum game of winners and losers. As you navigate the next few years at this wonderful institution, you will be told time and again that what you must chase is the pursuit of excellence. But I want you to keep this thought at the back of your head at all times. What is far more important is the pursuit of meaning. There is a very strong tendency to create a template of someone a few batches above you who you consider excellent and then pursue being like them. But here's the thing. Not only are you likely to hate the process and lose your individuality, the worst part is that you'll always fall short. You'll be stuck in an endless cycle of comparisons and playing catch-up because there will always be something your role model has achieved that you haven't done yet. So, what's my take? Go for every tryout and experiment with your interests. Sure, keep role models, but don't obsess over them. Once you find something that fills you with joy and you give that your all, excellence will pursue you. And excellence doesn't mean a man of the match trophy or a best delegate certificate. It means you're doing your best, and that is all that matters. Now, while you're on this journey, remember, it's easy to fall into the trap of doing an overwhelming number of things. It's easy to let time gain a hold on you and feel pressured and pulled in 100 different directions. But starting a stopwatch to chase your dreams is sometimes just as important as a stop and reset. Taking a moment out to just pause and remind yourself to not go crazy is perhaps the one thing I wish I followed as a chubby Sardar then and as a marginally less chubby, marginally less Sardar now. Batch of 2021, weirdly enough, those words, stop and reset, describe the phase we are in right now. Leaving the familiar to go out into the real world and start a new chapter of our lives from scratch. But we'll be okay. And I'm not just saying that because we're a weirdly talented batch with 1,000 social initiatives and Raseel runs 900 of those, but because we'll always have each other the way we have since 2007. Now, I wasn't there with you in junior school while you were shouted off the rocks by the bhaiyas or when you came to school one day to see your swings area replaced by a tire park. I never got to sing Michael Key Cycle with Manas sir, wear home clothes on my birthday and distribute sweets with my best friends. And thank God, I never had to sit through 5.5 hours of Mr. Mark Parkinson telling you about how he once played cricket with Ruskin Bond. But from the welcome I felt the second I entered this school, I knew that this was more than just a group of friends. This was a family. Regardless of the physical distance that might separate us in the future, we'll always be united by our memories. We'll never be able to get the tune of Make Me a Channel of Your Peace out of our heads, unsee pictures of dead chirus and tigers from Madhu Ma'am's environment sessions, or rid our tongues of the bitter aftertaste of CCD coffee even after 10 packets of sugar. We won't be able to shake off the physical pain of not being picked by Mr. Rajiv Makhni and then see our best friend win an iPhone. And we won't be able to forget the smell of absolute BS when our parents told us they enjoyed our form evening performance. Batch of 2021, you've always managed to transform ordinary experiences into extraordinary ones. Thank you for taking me into your big family and giving me the best 7 years anyone could ever dream of. It's so hard to not actually see you in here and only be giving the speech to Jasbir Bhaiya in the light box, but I can't wait to cross paths with you someday. Granted, it won't be the same. You hopefully won't be wearing an Angavastram, but I know we'll smile at each other and remember all the good times we had. Sriram School, it's been the honor of a lifetime to be your head boy, but most importantly, to be a member of the talented, quirky, and resilient batch of 2021. Because families last forever, I know this isn't the end of our journey, just a new beginning. So instead of goodbye, I leave you with three simple words. Until next time.
Thank you so much, Dhruv and Prithika, for your speeches and for everything else that you've done for us over the past year. There is no one else we would rather spend our time listening to, I promise you.
Next, we'll be moving on to a very exciting segment of today's ceremony, a TSRS first. 14 years of school, a lifetime of memories, and a place to forever call home. That's what the school leaves every single Ramite with when they graduate. Batch of 2021, we hope that you enjoy this nostalgic trip down memory lane, and we hope that it reminds you of your most cherished memories from school.
सूरज की बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी सूरज की बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी जो ही बदली दिल की ताल है आहा आया एक ख्याल है आहा बांटे हमें जिंदगी एक बार क्यों ना करे खुद हमें
स्विमिंग पूल इन सीनियर स्कूल एंड द लवली फ्रीडम
आई एम लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू द लवली स्पोर्ट्स फैसिलिटीज इन सीनियर स्कूल
I'm looking forward to the new environment in senior school.
You have a much bigger school and much more freedom there.
I'm looking forward to the basketball court.
I'm looking forward to the senior school overall.
I'm looking forward to the soccer field there.
I'm looking forward to the soccer field there.
I'm looking forward to some...
बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी सूरज की बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी कहो जिंदगी नए नए रास्ते जो चुन सके उसे जिंदगी को कहो जिंदगी पल पल में चलती हो झूम के चलती हो वो है जिंदगी सूरज की बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी सूरज की बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी बातें हमें जिंदगी एक बार क्यों न करे खुद ही हम इसको प्यार जाने किसका है हमें इंतजार कि जिंदगी बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी सूरज की बाहों में अब है ये जिंदगी किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी सूरज की अब है ये किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी सूरज की अब है ये किरने हैं सांसों में बातों में रोशनी
Hold on to me as we go.
We get what we want over here and we can do what we want and whatever we do is lots of fun.
Going to miss
lunch.
Lunch.
School lunch.
Life is stringing us along. Just know you're not alone. Cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
That was truly such a special video, and we hope that you were able to find yourself somewhere in there. Along the same lines of nostalgia, we now come to one of the most anticipated parts of this ceremony. Every year, we get a chance to see just how much you've all grown up during your school years through this very special segment. We hope that you enjoy watching it just as much as we did.
से बैठी हुई धुन ये इशारे दे कुछ मेरे राज तेरे राज आवारा से खो गए हम कहां रंग सा ये जहां खो गए हम कहां रंग सा
रंगों सा ये जहां तेरे में
तो इमारतें हैं, मैं भी हूँ तू भी है यहाँ। खोई सोई सड़कों पे, सितारों के कंधों पे हम नाचते उड़ते हैं यहाँ।
take the speed it's moving in. I know I can, 'cause now I see I'll never stop this train. से धीमे से मुझको बाहों में भर लो ना तुम, नरम सी सांसों में मुझको आहों में भर लो ना तुम। सुन जरा मेरे पास आ, अब बैठे हैं हम भी यहाँ दिल के दरमियाँ। बारिशें हैं तेरी ही बातों पे मैंने सजा ली है दुनिया यहाँ दिल के दरमियाँ। बारिशें अब तू आती है बुलाती है बिस्तर से यूं गिराती है कि सोऊं मैं बाहों में बस तेरी। जब बारिशें बरसती हैं पागल जैसे थिरकती है, तुम जैसी हो बस वैसी ही रहो। गिराते हैं तो और तू ही मेरे दिल की रजा है, तेरे बिना दिल भी खफा है तो। तेरी आंखों का काजल ना फैले अब कभी भी, तुझे इतना प्यार दूं। तेरी खुशियों की खातिर ये दुनिया मैं मेरी एक पल में वार दूं। अब बिखरी तेरी ये जुल्फों से आंखें तेरी जब दिखती हैं, दिखता है मुझे वो आसमान कि खोलूं पंख मैं मेरे उड़ जाऊं, मैं खो जाऊं मैं इस आसमान में पतंगों की तरह। Someone stop this train.
past go. One generation's led the way from fighting life out on my own. Stop this train, I wanna get off and go home again. I can't take the speed it's moving in. I know I can, but honestly, won't someone stop this train?
Thank you so much for that heartwarming presentation. We'd also like to take this opportunity to thank Janani ma'am, Meghna ma'am, the editorial board, the junior school teachers, and all the other class teachers. This ceremony wouldn't have been possible without you. With the school song one last time, and please rise for the national anthem.
Shri Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna.
Batch of 2021. We know that this year has been anything but normal, but your resilience in dealing with the situation will give you the strength to handle anything that the future might throw at you. Take pride in just how far you have come and have faith in how far you can go. I know that you'll probably hear this a million times today, but we're going to miss you more than you can ever imagine. And school will simply not be the same without you. Now, of course, in the spirit of our Shri Ram teachers, I'll end with a quote. Don't follow where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and leave your own trail. Once again, happy graduation day, and we'll see you very soon.